Dear students, my name is Sir Komal and today the topic of my lecture is decibel. In today's topic, I will tell you how you can calculate decibel. So first, we are writing the heading decibel. Short form is dB. In this lecture, I will tell you how you can calculate decibel. What is the need of decibel? Decibel is basically a unit to represent the large values. Bell is the name of the scientist who has used his own name to represent the large values with the help of a small number. So this is the need of decibel. With the help of it, we can actually represent large value gain into a small value, which is called dB. First of all, I will take the power P1, 1 raised to the power 6, which is called 1 megawatt. It is 100000 watts. Why it's 1 into 10 to the power 6? Because it has 6 zeros. Now if I take the power P2, 1 is to 10 raised to the power 3, which is 1000 watts. Divide P1 by P2 to find the power gain. The symbol of power gain is AP. A is the symbol of gain and P written in the subscript is showing that it's the symbol for power gain. So it is equal to 1 megawatt divided by 1 kilowatt. 1000 is cancelled by these 3 zeros and the answer is 1000. P1 divided by P2 is equal to 1000. This 1000 is unitless. Why? Because it is a ratio between two similar quantities. And you know, whenever we take the ratio between two similar quantities, it's unitless. So the power gain has a value 1000, which is unitless. Now look, this value 1000 is much bigger and it will be difficult for me to handle it, to write it, to use it in calculations, in measurements and add numericals. So I want it to be represented by a small value. This is the concept which the scientist Bell actually gave us. He told us how you can convert a large value gain into a small value, which is called decibel. First of all, you will take log of the ratio. The ratio P1 divided by P2, you will take log of this ratio. Then you will multiply 10 with this log. Now students, you will ask a question, sir, why are you multiplying 10 with the log? Because I want to convert it in decibel. When you are taking just log of P1 upon P2, it's converted into the unit which is called bel. And in the next step, you have multiplied it by 10. So now it's converted into the unit of decibel. So this is the formula for power gain. 10 log P1 upon P2, which is in the unit of dB. P1 upon P2 has a value 1000. So you will take log of 1000. Log of 1000 is 3. Then you will multiply 3 with 10. 3 10 the 30. So the answer is 30 dB. Answer is 30 dB. Now you can see 30 is a very much smaller number as compared to 1000. So this is the benefit of dB. This is an advantage of dB. With the help of dB, we can represent a large value gain by a small value. Now this 30 dB is very much easy for me to write it in numericals, to use it in calculations and in measurements. So it's very easy for me to handle now. That's why I have converted it into dB. So this is the formula of power gain in dB. Now if I want to find out the formula of voltage gain in dB, what I will do? You all know Ohm's law for power. Ohm's law for power is P is equal to V square upon R. Ohm's law for power is P is equal to V square upon R. P1 is equal to V1 square upon R. P2 is equal to V2 square upon R. Here R, resistance, is same in both the formula. Now keep these formulas of P1 and P2 into the formula of power gain. You will get the formula of voltage gain now, and the symbol is AV. You can see I have written V into the subscript. Why? Because it is now the voltage gain. So to represent voltage gain, we are using the symbol AV. So AV is equal to 10 log V1 square upon R divided by V2 square upon R. R will be cancelled by this R, and AV is equal to 10 log V1 square divided by V2 square. Now take the common square, so it will be 10 log V1 upon V2 whole square. This is the property of log. The power comes as a coefficient, so it will be 10 multiplied by 2 log of V1 upon V2, and 2 multiplied by 10 is 20. So the formula of voltage gain is 20 log V1 divided by V2. 20 log V1 divided by V2. And the formula for current gain is 20 log I1 divided by I2. So the lecture ends here. Thank you very much.